Two roads in Quezon City have been renamed after the late Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago. Let's get more details from Michael Delizo. Michael.
Hi, Rica. Good afternoon. The Quezon City government has formally renamed BIR and Agham roads after the late former Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago. The Senator Miriam Defensor Santiago Avenue spans from North Avenue, traverse through Quezon Avenue to East Avenue. Vice President Sara Duterte, Quezon City Mayor Joy Belmonte, Quezon City First District Representative Arjo Ataide, as well as Defensor Santiago's husband Narciso and her sister Linnea Evangelista, graced the renaming ceremony this morning. Earlier, the Malacanang said President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. allowed Republic Act No. 11963 to lapse into law on October 12. A bill lapses into law if the chief executive fails to act on it 30 days after the receipt from Congress. The measure was first passed by the House of Representatives on March 21 and then by the Senate on August 14 with no negative votes nor abstention. Duterte said Defensor Santiago was one of the Philippines' most distinguished and admired national leaders whose legacy should continue to inspire the future generations. Defensor Santiago's public service spanned the three branches of government, ran for president in the 2016 elections with Marcos Jr. as her running mate. She died on September 29, 2018 at the age of 71 because of cancer. Back to you, Rica.
Thank you so much, Michael Delizo, reporting live. A big-time oil price rollback is expected next week, but jeepney drivers claim the recent dip in fuel prices still fail to offset their losses. Jackie Manabat has the full story.
Jeepney drivers Ari and Victor are staying longer on the road and working more hours to offset high diesel prices. They say the recent price rollback didn't help.
Di talaga ganong naramdaman kasi mababa lang yung ano eh. Mababa lang yung binababa ng diesel. At saka yung inaano namin, imbis kukuha kaming apat na ikot or limang ikot, ngayon dinagdagan na lang namin, ginagawa namin pitong ikot o anim na ikot para lang kumikita kasi yung ano kasi namin, yung budget sana sa pamilya namin, napunta na sa diesel eh.
Hindi po ramdam eh. Sa taas po ng diesel talaga eh. Wala o. Katulad yung 500 po. Isang ikot lang po yan. Hanggang wala kami kinikita. Wala. Tsaga-tsaga na lang po. Hanggang doon na lang taga eh. Wala tayong magagawa dyan eh. Talagang sa taas ng diesel, talagang walang kinikita talaga. Asa ka dalo sa biyahe, imbis na umuwi kami ng alas 7, umuwi kami alas 10, alas 11.
But there is good news. For PUV drivers like Ari and Victor, a big-time rollback is expected based on the four-day exchange in the global market. Gasoline prices are expected to go down by 60 to 80 centavos per liter. And for kerosene, a possible decrease of up to 1 peso and 85 centavos per liter. Diesel, which is used by jeepneys, is expected to drop by 2 pesos and 40 centavos to 2 pesos and 70 centavos per liter. One possible reason is the slowdown in manufacturing activity in China and the United States. Fortunately, the tension in the Middle East has not affected global fuel prices. The DOE says the decline in the pump prices may continue until the next few months.
Kung tutuloy-tuloy na itong pagbaba, unless meron na namang gawin, unless ha, may gagawin na namang pronouncement itong OPEC, kung ano-ano namang cut ang gagawin. Mm-hmm. At kung lumala ang tension, but as of date, wala akong nangyayaring actual production cut. Oh. Brought about by Middle East tension. Wala akong actual ha. Mm-hmm. Puro lang yan is speculative at this point in time.
The price of petroleum products is expected to have a significant effect on the hearing set next week on the appeal to increase the jeepney fares. For some jeepney drivers, they are open to keeping fares the same as long as the price of diesel continues to drop. Jackie Manabat, ABS-CBN News.
Foreign direct investments into the Philippines remain low for the year. Data showed the country booked $789 million in FDI net inflows in August. That's a touch lower than the same period last year. The Philippine Central Bank says the drop is mainly due to a contraction in net investments in debt instruments of non-residents. Year-to-date, FDI net inflows are down nearly 13%. The BSP explains the slowdown may be due to investors' concerns over sustained uncertainty in the global economy. Japan, the U.S., Singapore, and Germany were the top sources of FDI in the first 8 months of the year. These investments were placed mainly in manufacturing and real estate. More politicians jumped to the political party of President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. Over 30 lawmakers and local officials took their oath as members of Partido Federal ng Pilipinas. Among the most notable, Interior Secretary Benhur Abalos, his family and allies in their bailiwick, Mandaluyong City. Later, Representative Richard Gomez and wife Ormoc City Mayor Lucy Torres Gomez were also sworn in as new PFP members. Marcos in August said all political parties were welcome to join and support PFP, following his earlier call for a coalition with like-minded parties. Philippine authorities seized over 100,000 SIM cards suspected to be used for cyber fraud during a raid in Binondo, Manila. Karen De Guzman tells us more.
The NBI Anti-Organized and Transnational Crime Division seized more than 100,000 SIM cards and text blast machines used for cyber fraud. The NBI conducted a raid after receiving a tip. A group staying at a condominium in Binondo, Manila was buying registered SIM cards with fully verified e-wallet accounts.
Bibilhin daw nila ito ng 2,000 and then pag okay naman yung account nila, ay bibigyan pa sila ng 2,000 monthly. Napaka-delikado noon kasi pag nagbigay ka ng OTP, magkakaroon na sila ng control dun sa SIM card mo eh.
The registered SIM cards were inserted into text blast machines, which send out messages with links directing victims to fake websites. These machines can transmit up to 2 million messages a day.
Hindi naman verified itong mga website na to. May tendency kasi na itong website na to ay kunwari-kunwaring website lang, pero mas-scam ka rin ito.
14 employees were arrested, including a Malaysian national who is said to be supervising one of their rooms in the alleged spamming hub. The suspects claim they were unaware of the illegal activities, adding they were enticed by the high salary.
Kinuha lang po kami tapos maglalagay lang po ng card. Yun lang po yung alam namin talaga, ma'am.
Ang saklap lang kasi parang naghahanap ako ng work para po makatulong sa pamilya. And then, ganito po yung nangyari.
They will face charges of violating the Access Device Law, Cybercrime Prevention Act, Radio Control Law, Data Privacy Act, and SIM Card Registration Act. The NBI vows to find the leader behind the illegal operation. Authorities are reminding the public to be vigilant against spam text messages and warn e-wallet users from selling their accounts.
Yung SIM card nyo, dapat ano yan, dapat protektahan nyo yan kasi yan, nakadikit yung pangalan nyo. Kung gagawin nila yan sa panluloko niyan, pati kayo madadamay doon. At doon naman sa mga katanggap na message, huwag tayo basta-basta mag-click dyan sa mga link na pinapadala.
Authorities are now coordinating with the telecommunication companies to identify the owners of the confiscated SIM cards. Karen De Guzman, ABS-CBN News.
The Philippine Justice Department begins its crackdown on government agencies possibly involved in pogo crimes. This comes after they raided another gaming operator in Pasay, believed to be a prostitution and torture den. They also found out authentic Philippine government IDs were being issued to foreign pogo workers. The DOJ says there could be fixers inside government agencies that are helping orchestrate the series of organized crimes involving pogos.
Yung common denominator talaga sa lahat na ito ay organized crime siya. Hindi ito basta-basta magagawa ng pangkaraniwang kriminal. Ano? Napakaraming resources ang kailangan maipasok. At kailangan maraming tao ang involved. Madali na isipin na may mga tumutulong dyan, no, sa mga iba-ibang government agencies kasi di naman naabot sa punto na to na ganyan sila kalakas, ganyan sila kakampante, na walang tumutulong sa kanila. Kailangan natin tingnan yung mga ahensya na nag-issue ng mga IDs na yan, whether it's BIR, PhilHealth, kung sino bang may pakanan yan sa loob at kung mananagot ba dapat yung taong yun.
Philippine authorities recover an abandoned vehicle that may be connected with the disappearance of beauty queen Catherine Camilon. The red Honda CR-V had no license plates when it was found at a vacant lot in Batangas City. The police are working to identify its owner. Witnesses earlier claimed to have seen a bloodied woman, believed to be Camilon, being brought by three male suspects into a same vehicle. Another car at the scene has been traced to a police major with whom Camilon was allegedly in a romantic relationship. Investigators say Camilon was supposed to meet with a police major before she went missing on October 12th.
Nakikita natin diyan ay maaaring napanood na ng mga suspects natin itong naging pahayag natin at even yung CADG na nagkakaon na ng positive identification yung mga witnesses natin. May mga CCTV footages na tayong hawak. Siguro out of desperation, iniwan na nila itong sasakyan na ito.
China issues a stern warning to the Philippines. In a statement, the Chinese Coast Guard said it will continue exercising maritime law enforcement unless the Philippines stops what it calls infringement in disputed waters. This remark after the Philippine government lodged another diplomatic protest against China over its Coast Guard's dangerous maneuvers against Philippine vessels on a resupply mission in Ayungin Shoal. Philippine authorities also said Chinese boats fired water cannons at Philippine vessels. Meanwhile, Manila's former national security advisor believes China's moves are not meant to provoke the Philippines.
Hindi ba ang daming nagpopromesa sa atin si Pompeo nung panahon ni Trump, tapos ngayon si Blinken sa panahon ni Biden, na sila ay tutulong sa atin kung meron man mangyari dyan. Actually, yung sa akin ang mga actions ng China na yan, yung escalating bellicose actions nila, ay talagang memo sa US. Na-taunt niya yung US eh.
China claims nearly the whole of South China Sea, claims that were rejected by a landmark international ruling in 2016. Philippine government officials and international leaders condemn China's latest aggression in the West Philippine Sea. We have Victoria Tulad on the line with that. Vicky.
Rica, one of those who castigated China's recent actions, which went as far as using its Coast Guard's water cannon on a Philippine boat, is Senator Jinggoy Estrada, chairperson of the Senate Committee on National Defense and Security, Peace, Unification, and Reconciliation. In a statement, Estrada said China should be made to stop its illegal activities. He also recommended filing a resolution before the United Nations General Assembly to put an end to the violation of the Philippines' established rights in the West Philippine Sea and to cease the harassment of Philippine vessels. Senator Risa Ontiveros called China an abuser and a gaslighter who should be stopped. She asked government to double its efforts to educate the public about the truth that the West Philippine Sea is ours. House Speaker Martin Romualdez described China's reaction to a routine operation as dangerous and a blatant disregard for the diplomatic processes of the Philippines. He called on the international community, especially allies and the ASEAN, or Association of Southeast Asian Nations, to denounce China's actions and uphold freedom of navigation, the rule of law, and peace. In a social media post, United States Ambassador to the Philippines, Mary Kay Carlson, said the U.S. and Philippines stand together as friends, partners, and allies for a free and open Indo-Pacific. Japanese Ambassador Koshikawa Kazuhiko stated that any harassment and actions which increase tensions are not tolerated. Germany and the European Union expressed support for the Philippines, while the Australian Embassy emphasized the need to uphold international law, especially the United Nations Convention on the Law of the Sea. Rica?
Thank you so much, Victoria Tulad, reporting live.